Well, now I have the pleasure of talking individually with our 10 semifinalists in the interview competition. And because our title holders' communication skills are so important, our interviews are spontaneous, they're unrehearsed, and the ladies are judged on their poise, their intelligence, their personality, and of course the content of their answers. Now, for those contestants who have requested them, we have De La Vega Professional Translating Services standing by, and we begin with Miss India, Sushmita Sen. She's an 18-year-old model from New Delhi who enjoys writing poetry in her spare time. Now, I heard you say earlier during the Parade of Nations that your country, in your country, love is the essence of life. What did you mean by that?
Well, India is a country that everybody knows has multinational people, as in people with different languages, people with different religions. And we have about 168 languages, and people all live together. And there is, to quite an extent, a lot of peace, which is very difficult with so many religions staying together. And that is why I said love is the essence of life in India. Thank you.
Now, you have got to be a very, very public figure in India, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, but you also describe yourself as a private person. Now, how do you get the two working together?
Well, I think every human being must have two faces. It's very essential. One which you have for people in public, and one which you have for yourself. Because these two different things, when mixed together, makes you a person who has just a personality which is fit for everybody else, but not for one's own self. And I think it's very essential that you have a private side to yourself. I have it too.
All right, that's Sushmita Sen, Miss India. Thank you very much. And if you just step right over here, please. Right over there. Next up, we have Miss Venezuela. She's 22-year-old Menorca Mercado of Caracas, a university student and member of the Venezuelan national volleyball team. So clearly you are a serious athlete. How has sports shaped your life?
¿Cómo es que los deportes han forjado tu vida?
De una manera muy positiva, me han ayudado a que la mujer tiene que ser trabajadora, luchadora. Me han despertado ese deseo de superación, de que hay que luchar por esos principios morales que nuestra familia nos inculcan desde pequeño.
In a very positive way, sports have taught me that a woman must work hard and she must overcome and be a struggler, a fighter. And it has also taught me that I must follow the moral values that my family has taught me since I was a youngster.
Now, being part of this volleyball team is kind of a legacy for your family, isn't it?
El formar parte del equipo de voleibol es como parte de la herencia de tu familia, ¿no es así?
Efectivamente, toda mi familia es deportista. Mi mamá, en sus años de juventud, fue preseleccionada para la selección nacional de vole. Y bueno, ahora el sueño se hizo realidad cuando yo integro la selección nacional de vole.
Yes, as a matter of fact, my whole family participates in sports. My mother, when she was younger, she was preselected for the Venezuelan national volleyball team, and now I fulfill that because I am part of the national Venezuelan volleyball team.
All right, thank you very much, Miss Venezuela. That is Menorca Mercado. Now we have Miss Greece, Ria Totunzi. She's a 20-year-old from Athens who speaks three languages and enjoys ballet and modeling. What attracted you to modeling?
I really like the glamour of it. And I've felt that I should have been a model since I was really young. It's just that it's just there for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just a spotlight.
What's the best thing about it? Just being the glamour?
The glamour, and that you're on stage and people expect something from you. You know, and you have to show yourself, right. And what you're wearing is just wonderful for me.
Right, so you feel pretty comfortable up here in front of all these people.
Not quite. This is different. I'm getting judged here.
Yeah. That's okay, though.
Not the same.
Yeah, well, that's okay. But you speak three languages, right? Where did you learn to speak English so well?
I learned it in school, back in Athens.
Uh-huh. Have you ever had much association with Americans?
Yes, I did. I did. There was the American base in Athens. And most of my friends were Americans. And I've been to an English-speaking school for a while, and that's how I picked up the language. My dad is also Lebanese, so he doesn't speak the language, my language, Greek.
Right.
So.
Okay, great. Nice job. Thank you very much, Miss Greece. That's Ria Totunzi. You can step right over there so the judges can take a look at you. now Miss Switzerland. This is Patricia Fassler. She's born in Zurich, a 19-year-old university student majoring in languages. What do you hope to do when you complete your education?
When I finish with my education, I want to study medicine and I want to become a pediatrician.
Really? You want to work with kids, huh?
Yes, I want to, because I love children and I think children are our future.
Now, I also heard that you either did or want to climb the Matterhorn. Is that right?
Yes, it was an idea because in Switzerland, the Matterhorn is one of the biggest mountains, and it's very difficult to climb up to the mountain. So I said, Patricia, you go there and you climb up the mountain, you just try it, and because it's a wonderful feeling if you are on the top of the mountain and you can see all over Switzerland. It's very nice. It's a wonderful view.
So are you an avid mountain climber, or this is just the one thing you want to do?
Yes, it's one thing that is here and here, and I just want to try.
All right, well, we wish you luck on that climb. Good luck to you. Miss Switzerland, that is Patricia Fassler. Step right over there, please. And finally, Miss USA, Lou Parker. She's a 26-year-old high school teacher from Charleston, South Carolina. Hi, Lou. And the founder of a new program called HATS, which stands for Helping All Teens Survive.
Yes.
Tell me about that program.
Well, HATS is very important to me. I'm an educator, and I started HATS, Helping All Teens Survive, because of some unfortunate suicides and pregnancies. But it's a peer outreach program that takes care of teens that are in need.
And did I hear that they're going to open a chapter here in Manila?
Actually, yes, I was interviewing with the Herald Tribune, and this gentleman interviewed me for like 20 minutes or so, and then he said, you know, I'm really interested in your program, and I about lost it at that moment, because it would be my first international affiliate. But I have them in the States, in about five states, but not anywhere internationally, so I was very excited.
Wow, that's great. Now, if you should come here and open a chapter, you're going to have to learn a little bit of the native language, right?
Yeah. Well, actually, I've been here so long, I feel like a local. You know, I'm learning the language a little bit.
Tagalog?
You know?
Can you speak some?
A little bit.
Go ahead. Give me a shot.
Do you want me to say it to the audience or to you?
Yeah. Should she say it to you? Yeah.
Okay. Hello, if I came back. Magandang umaga, sanyong lahat. Nag-enjoy ako. Salamat pa. Salamat po. Sanyong lahat. Mahakita.
You must have done something right. What'd you say?
I said, good morning to all of you. I've enjoyed my stay. Thank you to all of you, and I love you.
Okay, that's Lou Parker, Miss USA. Go on right over there if you would, Lou. All right, thanks a lot, ladies. That completes our first five interviews.